Jess and I'm a puppeteer, and today we're going to be exploring shadows. Now, I love making shadows because all you need is a torch, an object, and a surface. Shadows are all around us, and if you're anything like me, once you start looking for them, you'll be spotting them everywhere. Now, a shadow occurs when an object is blocking out the light from a light source, like this torch or the sun, and it creates a shadow on a surface. So the shadow is a two-dimensional silhouette of the object which is standing in front of the light source. Now we can change the shadow by moving the surface. Goat gets bigger, goat gets smaller. Or by moving our object. Or by moving our light source. So, why don't you pop off now, pause me, and go and find some objects, a surface, and a torch. And meet me back here when you're done experimenting. Transparent means that you can see through something, whereas opaque means you can't. This cup is transparent, and our goat is opaque. And the shadows that they create are very different. So our goat's shadow is very solid and very dark, whereas the shadow created by this cup is very faint and almost ghostly. Boop. What's fun about transparent objects is that you can use them with opaque objects and do things like capturing a goat. You can also find transparent objects that are colourful, like the sweet wrapper. And with a sweet wrapper like this, we can colour our scene. Cool. Why don't you pause me now, go off and have a look, see if you can find lots of opaque objects and lots of transparent ones, and maybe even some colourful transparent ones. I'll meet you back here in a sec. Now we can have a little look at our objects and notice how in shadow they can appear as something different. So this rain mac, for example, it's see-through, but in shadow, it can appear as a mountain or an iceberg. Or these twigs. Now they're just little twigs from a bush, and I'm sticking them to the table with a little bit of blue tack. Put this one here. Now with these, I can change the scale of my picture by adding, let's welcome back, our goat. Suddenly, now, they're tall trees. And I can give the picture depth by adding in some more twigs closer to the light source. Oh yeah. Hmm. Now, I can also combine objects like this. So here are some transparent cartons, and I've stuck them together to create a building. Now, it doesn't look much in the light, but as soon as you put it in shadow, suddenly it starts to look rather grand. And now we've made a little shadowscape, we can decide what kind of story it's telling. What do all of these clues tell us? Well, I think it's probably winter because there aren't any leaves on the trees. And this does look like a very grand building, but this goat is here. So what could it be? Maybe it's the future, 2050, when goats rule the world. So off you pop now and go and find some bits and pieces to put together from your collection and make your own shadow landscape. Movement brings things to life, so now we can get a bit inventive with our light source. If we move it around, the shadows will change. For instance, with this object here, if I move the light source closer, the object gets bigger. If I move it farther away, it gets smaller. If I lift the light source above, our object gets shorter. And if I bring it down, our object grows. I can even keep my light source very close to the table and weaving round everything, I can make it look like we're travelling through our cityscape. You know what? I think I need a bigger surface. Perfect. So all I've done here is hang a bedsheet from a washing line and I've turned the lights out. And so you can do something similar at home. And what's really cool about this is that you've made a kind of shadow theatre. So you, the puppeteer, can be this side of things and then your friends can sit over the other side and you can put on a show and they won't know how the magic is done. You could use colourful, transparent objects to colour your landscape. So for instance, something pink could make it dawn, or something blue could mean you're underwater, or you could combine them to have something a bit more abstract. We can even bounce the light source by using something like this little handheld mirror. So instead of holding the light source directly up to the object, we can hold the mirror up to the object and then shine the light on the mirror. What happens is it makes a kind of spotlight. Whoa. And you can focus on different bits of your landscape. Or even you can decide to have a moon. Finally, you can use two light sources at once. See what happens when I do that. Super trippy. Hopefully, I've given you lots of inspiration and ideas to make your own shadow landscapes. Now, please, as well, we would love to see the photos of the things that you found, the things that you put together, the landscapes that you made. And if you tweet us or you email us, we can put it up on the Potential Difference website. Also, be sure to check out my friend Laurie's videos, because she's doing some amazing stuff with object manipulation and making your own puppet. Until next time, bye!